evening, everybody. I guess I'll start here by reading the annual meeting notice. Notice is hereby given that the annual meeting of the Belgrade Cooperative Association will be held at 6:30 p.m. Friday, 21st, at the Padua Pub. Purpose of this meeting will be to elect two directors and to conduct other such business that is brought properly before the voting members and the board of directors. And then I guess, once we get it up on the screen here, we're going to do the Pledge of Allegiance, so if you want to stand with me, we'll meet you now. I
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Lord God, we thank you for the opportunity of being involved in agriculture. The stewardship of caring for your creation is a privilege that's shared by the cooperative and its member producers. We ask for your blessing for a favorable growing season 2020. We ask that you give us wisdom as we make our choices as a cooperative and decisions as a producer member. Lord, we especially ask you to be with us tonight as we conduct the business of the cooperative. Give us vision as we navigate the economic and weather cycles that challenge us. Give us patience to wait for the right opportunities to keep our cooperative strong. Most importantly, we pray for the safety of our producer members and our cooperative staff in 2020. Bless our food and may we enjoy the fellowship of our friends and neighbors tonight.
Amen. Thanks, Jim. All right, we'll call to order the 91st annual meeting of the Belgrade Co-op. We'll start out with the board introductions. I'm Mark Walsh, chairman. Jeremy Mears, secretary. We've got Keith Overman, Gary Meyer, Jeremy Hoffenkamp, and Justin Anderson. Now we'll get Jeremy for the secretary's report.
The annual meeting was January 18, 2019 at the Padua Pub. Was the 90th meeting. Meeting was called to order by Chairman Mark Walsh. Mark introduced the board of directors. All members were present and approximately 150 patrons. The official notice of the annual meeting and the minutes from the January 15, 2018 annual meeting were read by myself. There was a motion and a second to approve those minutes, and the motion carried. The annual financial report was presented by Carol Nealand of Pennon & Associates. The net sales for the year were $5.9 million, with expenses of $4.9 million, and a local profit of $1 million, with patronage and LLC income, for a total profit for the year was $1.5 million. Gary Meyer reported on the activities of the board of directors over the past year. Then Jeff presented his manager's report. There was no old business brought before the meeting, and there was no new business brought before the meeting. Gary introduced the candidates for the board of directors. Mark Walsh, an incumbent, was running for his third term. And Keith Oberman, incumbent, was running for his second term. There were no further nominations received from the floor. Gary Meyer then called for a unanimous ballot to re-elect Mark Walsh and Keith Oberman. The motion was made and seconded, and the motion carried. There was no further business, and the meeting was adjourned.
Are there any additions or corrections to the secretary's report? With no further additions or corrections to the secretary's report, I'd seek a motion to approve as read. Motion's been made to approve the secretary's report as read. For a second. Motion's been made and seconded to approve the secretary's report. Everybody in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion's been carried. All right, now we'll call Carol up from Hennen Associates for the annual audit report.
Thank you. statement of operations, which is on page 2 if you'd like to follow along. Or if it's in the book, or it's also up on the screens here. First column is for this year compared to a year ago. Your total sales this year were $32.8 million, which are up about $600,000, less the cost of those sales of $26.2 million. You have a gross margin of $6.5 million, which is an increase of $565,000. From that gross margins, you have some expenses to pay. The first and foremost expense is the personnel expenses of $2.7 million, which is within $22,000. The general expenses, that's the expense of maintaining the buildings and equipment of $2.2 million, which are up $136,000. Administrative expenses of $376,000, which is real comparable to last year. Interest and other unusual expenses is an increase in expenses of $112,000. So you add these four areas up and your total expenses are $5.2 million, which are up $269,000. You subtract that from your gross margins and you have a local savings of $1.3 million, which is a nice increase of $296,000. To that, you did receive some patronage from other cooperatives, such as CHS and Land O'Lakes, of $473,000. So your net savings this year was $1.8 million, which was an increase of $287,000. And this is what you're receiving tonight in your patronage check. So for on the average, for every gallon of gas you bought, you received 11 cents a gallon tonight. For every gallon of fuel on the average that you bought, you received 14 cents. As far as lube products, it averages out 28 cents a gallon. And for LP, on the average selling price, you received a nickel tonight in your patronage check. Any questions or comments on your statement of operations? If not, thank you. We'll turn to page 3 and we will go through the balance sheet. First columns for this year compared to last year. First, we have the assets, and the current assets are the assets that can be readily turned into cash within a year of $8.8 million, which are up about $57,000. The property, plant, and equipment, the original cost is close to $17 million. Less the accumulated depreciation of $10.3 million, so you have a book value of $6.6 million, which is an increase of about $303,000. Then investments and other assets, these would be like investments in cooperatives and LLCs of $3.9 million, which are up $10,000. So you add these three areas up and your total assets are $19.4 million, which is an increase of $371,000. And then balancing to your total assets are your liabilities and patron equities. First is your current liabilities. Those are the liabilities that are usually due and payable within a year, of $4.2 million, which are down $129,000. Long-term debt, that would be the debt that's due over a year of $146,000. Deferred tax liability, that's basically the difference between book and tax depreciation. So your total liabilities are $4.8 million. You add your patron equities of $14.6 million. You should balance to your total liabilities and patron equities of $19.4 million. So in this last year, the cash and the stock that was returned to you was about $758,000. And so over the last 6 years, that's about $6 million. Then if you take your current assets less your current liabilities, you get your working capital. And your working capital was the highest it had been in 6 years, in the last 6 years, of $4.6 million. So you have a very strong balance sheet. Very strong company, and it's all because of you patrons working together cooperatively to have a very strong company. Any questions or comments on your balance sheet and or your statement of operations? If not, thank you.
Thanks, Carol. There's no further questions or comments on the annual audit report. We'll seek a motion to approve as read. Motion's been made to approve the audit report as read. Is there a second? Motion's been made and seconded to approve the audit report. Everybody in favor say aye. Opposed, same sign. Motion's been carried. Now I'd invite Manager Jeff Kaler up here for the manager's report.
Okay, thank you, Mark. Before I get started, I need to clear the air on something. A year ago in January, I was at an agronomy meeting down in Benson, and there was a meteorologist there that said, hey, the Pacific Ocean is warm and the Atlantic Ocean is cold. It's looking like 2019 is going to be this special growing season year, and it'll be a very good growing season. And so my next board meeting, I came back to those guys and I go, hey guys, guess what? 2019 is going to be an awesome year. It's going to have nice sunny days, and it's just going to work out really well. So anyway, what I'm going to tell you, it didn't turn out that way. It was probably one of the worst years ever, and it's my fault. And if you want to roll up your drink tickets and throw them at me, that's just fine. So fast forward to this year, we get to December, and we're talking about the annual meeting, and I go, hey, I got this great idea. Let's postpone it until the end of February because the weather's going to be great and we don't have to worry about snow and blowing snow and all that icky stuff. And they're like, yeah, right. Remember last year? But anyway, it turned out good, and so we'll take credit for a nice day and a good turnout. I have a couple thank yous to do, and the first one, like Carol said, is to you, the patrons, the support that you gave us in 2019 through all that was amazing, and we just really, really appreciate that from all the staff and from everybody that works on the co-op. At the co-op, it's just awesome how you support us in good and bad times. And so thank you for your patronage, and thank you for trusting us with your business. I thought I would reflect a little bit. And so I started this job in 1995. That just happens to be 25 years ago. And so one of the things that happened, you know, I had mentors of Alan Henderson and Kenny Eikens from Benson. And anyway, Kenny taught me something one time. He says, you know, when you guys have a good year, then just take credit for it. And if you have a bad year, blame it on the weather. And so I've kind of stuck with that advice. But anyway, in 25 years, the cooperative has gone from $4.8 million to $32.8 million this year. And again, that's just a thank you out to you guys for growing with the company. And it's awesome. The second page is a little historical on dividend and retirement equity. And so that, two behind, so good. Okay. Anyway, the next slide is a dividend retirement equity. And that would show that over the last 25 years, the cooperative has returned in cash to the members just a little over $11 million. And of that, it equals 2.5% of all sales, which is just about $500 million in that period of time. And so there's one other aspect of that, and that is most of you have allocated equity, but there's also a unallocated equity of $4.6 million. And so that's really owned by all of you. That's over and above the equity that you show on your statements to me. The projects that we took on last year, the first one was an update to the convenience store, and that building was in place 1997, and so we did some updates to the blocks and to the front and to the image of it, the conference room, and so that was one of the projects that we did in 19. The next project that we did in 19 was it was a 3-year project, and it ended up with construction of additional fertilizer, dry fertilizer storage. And what drove that was the fact that over the last 7 years, we've seen a conversion of nitrogen going from anhydrous ammonia to urea, and that is what drove the addition the most. And then how that's calculated is it's pretty much 2-for-1. So it takes 2 pounds of urea to equal 1 pound of anhydrous ammonia in rough speaking. And so as the need for nitrogen has grown and the sales of ammonia have stayed the same or gone down a little bit, it's essential that we have more dry storage for the quick pace of the spring. And so that's our bigger project last year. And so I'll go to the next slide, and it shows a little video of construction.
There are people in this country who work hard every day. Not for fame or fortune do they strive. But the fruits of their labor are worth more than their pay. And it's time a few of them recognize. Hello, Detroit auto worker. Let me thank you for your time. You work a 40-hour week for a living. Let's send it on down the line. Hello, Pittsburgh steel mill worker. Let me thank you. Send Hello, America. Let me thank you for your
fastest $488,000 you guys have ever spent. Okay, looking ahead, there's a quote that I put on the screen there. When things change, the customer experience becomes paramount. And so what that means, looking ahead for 2020, is that we've spend a lot of time thinking about how we connect with you guys from a digital standpoint. And there's different medias, and the Belgrade Co-op is fortunate to have a wonderful team of people that's making this happen. And the first step in going into 2020 is we're looking at our statements, and there'll be three options for our statements. Our statement is major communication piece, because guess what? You get it every month, and it gives us a scorecard on how we're doing in communicating what's owed and what's prepaid and all those things. So the options will be a combination statement, a simple statement, and then starting in 2020, we're going to be able to be online, and so you will be able to do a wireless. That'll also include a Co-op Connect, which is a portal that will have field records, statements, invoices, payment options, and contracting. The next part of our digital connection is the grower information part, and that's through our website. And the website has a product calendar, agronomy training, invite to growers for different events, clinics, in-season insights, analytics, and seller follow-up. And so this is going to enhance our agronomists and our sales people in that we can communicate to you as growers and producers electronically through email, through text, or having you go to our website for the latest agronomic information that they're seeing in the country. The next slide is really the part that helps us understand what we do as an agronomy team and how we think about things. And so that's the modern basketball diagram of what's it worth to shoot threes versus twos. And so if you do the math on that, it's 225 bushel corn versus 166. And so as an agronomy company, our goal is to help you make threes. And there's a lot of different things that happen to help you make threes, but your threes is a 225 bushel average. And so that's how we want to influence our agronomy folks, and that's how a way of thinking at it is that we've changed from what 2 points are worth to what 3 points are worth, and so that's how we look at it as an agronomy company. The last thank you that I want to give is to the staff at Belgrade Co-op. They're a great team of people, and also a big thank you to the directors. We've got a lot of diversity and a lot of talent in the staff and the directors, and I just thank them for their leadership. Concluding tonight, I've got something from the past. We, in 1994 or 5, we did a banquet like this. And it wasn't our annual meeting, but we had a group, Katie and Charlie, and they did the farm poem. And so I pulled one off of the a modern one of the farmer. And so it's Amelia Barr, and so I'm going to play that for you in concluding my report. Thank you for coming, and enjoy the rest of the evening.
The king may rule over land and sea. The Lord may live right royally. The soldier ride in pomp and pride. The sailor roam over ocean wide. But this or that, whatever befall, the farmer, he must feed them all. The writer thinks, the poet sings, the craftsman fashion wondrous things. The doctor heals, the lawyer pleads, the miner follows, the precious leads. But this or that, whatever befall, the farmer, he must feed them all. The merchant, he may buy and sell, the teacher do his duty well. But men may toil through busy days, or men may stroll through pleasant ways. From king to beggar, whatever befall, the farmer, he must feed them all. The farmer's trade is one of worth. He's partner with the sky and earth. He's partner with the sun and rain, and no man loses for his gain. And men may rise, or men may fall, but the farmer, he must feed them all. God bless the man who sows the wheat, who finds us milk and fruit and meat. May his purse be heavy, his heart be light, his cattle and corn and all go right. God bless the seeds his hands let fall. For the farmer, he must feed us all.
It's on the bottom, and this, I believe, is going to be available to watch too later on through our web. So if you guys wanted to go back and look at that, watch the temperatures on the bottom of that. Yeah, it's down in the teens. A lot of rain, a lot of snow. All right, with that being said, I'll ask Gary Meyer to come up here for the board report.
Good evening. Jeff had thanked the staff and the directors, and I think we also need to thank Jeff for 25 years of leadership. And the 30 years is a nice round number, so we're kind of hoping to. I'd like to share a brief summary of the board's responsibilities for 2019. Monthly, we review the financial statements, capital budget purchases, and pay estates. Twice a year, we review the audit report and also stock and dividend payout plans. Annually, the agronomy and petroleum staff give a presentation and update. We reveal sales, profit and loss, and capital expense budgets. We updated the 2019 credit process and reviewed any bad debt. We have our general manager review. we reviewed the Atlas website and also signed a 3-year contract with our audit company. Tax planning is done with Russ Bunhart, the co-op's income tax accountant. Throughout the year, we plan and attend special meetings such as CoBank customer meeting in Fargo, Land O'Lakes annual meeting in Minneapolis, Minnesota Directors Association meeting in Morris, and our summer appreciation and year retirement in Bruton. We also attended a long-range planning session. In 2019, the board approved property and equipment purchases of $1,667,072 and paid $761,665 to our members. Thank you.
Thanks, Gary, for the board report. All right, is there any old business to be brought before the board? Any old business? Without being any old business to be brought before the board, we'll look for new business to be brought before the board. Any new business to be brought before the board? With no new business to be brought before the board, I would ask Keith Overman to come up for the nominating committee report.
Hello, everybody. This is an important part of the meeting also. We need to hold elections for the board. There's two positions open this year, currently being held by Jeremy Pierce and Chad Brailman. As you can see on your ballot, if you picked one up, they have both agreed to rerun. At this point, I'm going to also open up the nominations from the floor. If anybody wants to nominate somebody, I'll ask three times. So, at this point, is there any other nominations for the board of directors? Are there any other nominations from the floor? Third and final time, is there any other nominations from the floor? Well, hearing none, I'm going to close nominations. If you've got your ballot, you've seen on here that Jeremy and Chad have given you a little bit of bio on themselves. Jeremy, if you want to stand up and show who you are. And Chad Brailman couldn't be here tonight. He had some personal reasons, and we'll let him by with that. So I guess to conclude this, is anybody willing to cast an unanimous ballot for this ballot? And I got a motion over here. Is there a second? I got a second. So I'm going to call for a vote on this. All in favor of casting an unanimous ballot for Jeremy Pierce and Chad Brailman, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say in sign. Hearing none, I guess we have two directors for something coming here. Thank you.
Thanks, Keith. With no further stuff to be brought before the board, I would call for an adjournment of the meeting. Got a motion to adjourn the meeting. Is there a second? Seconded to adjourn the meeting. Everybody in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion is carried to adjourn the meeting. Lisa's got some words. Okay, please remain seated. They will come around to your tables to get drinks, and then they will come around to your tables to dismiss you to go get food. Thanks.
Thank you.